What is the best dosage of MOTS-c for bodybuilding? Now, this is a great question because if you're using MOTS-c for bodybuilding, a lot of people are like, I thought that was for like endurance and AMPK. And here's the truth that we're gonna unpack in this video is MOTS-c is a myostatin inhibitor, and it's a very phenomenal peptide for muscle building that most people miss. They don't realize this aspect of this wonderful peptide. So by the end of this video, you're going to know, you know, how to utilize it, what other peptides you can stack it with if you're looking for that follistatin expression, and you'll know exactly what to do when it comes to bodybuilding. So send a before and after picture, post it in the comments. All right, so MOTS-c. Phenomenal. So bodybuilders will use this, and this is a very rare subset. These are the most educated bodybuilders. And the thing I love about you guys is you actually brought peptides to the forefront. You were willing to try these before they were tested on humans in many cases. And then I've been able to learn from you, and then the pharmacists and the medical community that I'm in, we all have learned from you. And so I really appreciate the work that you've done because you've understood the mechanism of action for the most part. I know not all bodybuilders, you know, some of you guys are just, you take your friend's advice on it, but there is some real science with it. And so if you're getting your labs ran, that is ground level for anyone, whether you think you know or not, whether you know peptides really well. It all starts with getting the right testing, and the blood labs help determine what the dose will be if you're bodybuilding. But generally speaking, it's going to be 5 milligrams, roughly 3 times per week. And that seems to be a very good dose, at least a starting place. If you ramp it up too fast, your body may create this, what's called an immunogenic response, where you may get like a little bit of a racing heart rate. You may have a little rash. So just work up slow and make sure that your immune system tolerates this one. But when it comes to weightlifting and bodybuilding, I look at the body as having what I call the ageless axis. So you've got your heart, you've got your brain, and you've got your muscles. And the largest organ in your body are your muscles, believe it or not. And most people don't even think of the muscles as an organ. Yes, the largest surface area is your skin, but the muscle takes up the most mass in your body, roughly, you know, 35 to 38% for females and about 40% for males. And if you're a bodybuilder, it may even be more than that. And so if you think of taking MOTS-c, one of the benefits is when you inhibit myostatin, myostatin's the brake. So any system in your body, it has a gas pedal and a brake. And then you put an input into your body, and maybe that input is, hey, let's take off the brakes and let Regan build a little more muscle faster. So I take MOTS-c, and then I get more follistatin increase. Now, follistatin has gotten a lot of notoriety. You know, you hear Brian Johnson went and got follistatin gene therapy. I had another doctor out of the Virgin Islands who's doing medical tourism where they're doing follistatin gene therapy. It's not FDA approved, and it's right now it's illegal in the United States. There's people doing it in Mexico and other places, but for good reason, because when you're editing your genes, it doesn't always end well. And so we want to make sure that the safety first, nothing that we do at Ageless Future is going to compromise your future health. That's our vision, that's our goal. And so we're always looking at the data, the details in the labs, and then applying different inputs with peptides or hormones or regenerative medicine. And then we want to see what the outcome is. So it's a pure scientific approach. You know, we have a hypothesis. Okay, you want to be a bodybuilder. You want to build X amount of muscle in Y amount of time. How are we going to get you there the fastest way? But how can we do it without risking future health? And MOTS-c is a great way of doing that, because anytime you put the brakes on the myostatin, you get more follistatin expression. There's a very interesting peptide that's also a myostatin inhibitor called ACE031. And these are two of the major peptides. MOTS-c and ACE031 are two of the major peptides for muscle building, because most people are thinking more on the anabolic side of things, which is testosterone, which is a phenomenal muscle builder. There's probably nothing better than testosterone that I know of for building muscle. But once again, if you're expressing testosterone too greatly, there's going to be side effects. And so MOTS-c and ACE031 seem to be working on this other pathway called follistatin and myostatin. So they seem to work really well. There's another peptide, follistatin 341, I believe, and that peptide is another one that expresses follistatin. So if you can think of this, then you go over to the growth hormone and testosterone pathways, and you'll get an even better response because your body can recover and adapt to the hypertrophy that you're imposing upon yourself in the gym when you're lifting weights. So for those of you who aren't bodybuilders, just think of this through body composition, because your muscle is such an important organ system. Your muscles release this peptide called myokines, and it informs your brain as to the amount of activity that you're undergoing. It informs your brain to regulate your glucose metabolism. So it's one of the fastest ways to get out of like an insulin resistance or type 2 diabetic response just by building muscle. The other thing that you'll see happen with really healthy muscles is it informs your heart. So it gives you this new cardiovascular network where your body has better endurance, better flexibility. So muscle is just really beautiful thing that we get to carry around. And yes, it helps us move. We have muscles that help us push things away, pull things in. It helps us walk, run, all those great things. So when you're looking at bodybuilding, one of the strategies that we've deployed with other clients is get your labs ran. And then what we'll do is cycles of MOTS-c. And you do that for about 60 days. And then you bring in ACE-031. And you do that for 60 days. Now, ACE-031, it was studied in postmenopausal women who were developing sarcopenia. So they had reduction in the health of their blood vessels. They had a reduction in muscle mass and an increase in adiposity. And specifically, they looked at the measurements of their legs. And just by using ACE-031 weekly injections over 28 days, so four injections. And what they found is these women, they lost 9% of that visceral fat in their legs and gained 4% of lean muscle. So phenomenal. So that's one of the ways you can cycle it. The other thing that you want to consider stacking with it is like tesamorelin and ipamorelin. So tesamorelin is a growth hormone releasing peptide. This one is FDA approved. It was approved with HIV patients who had lipodystrophy, so they had a lot of fat built up around their livers and their organ systems, and then they had belly fat. And just by being on tesamorelin, on average, they lost 19% of their body fat. And that was over the course of about 26 weeks. 26 to 52 weeks is what most of these studies went on to. So if you add in the growth hormone releasing peptides in your bodybuilding pursuits, those can be really important. And the other thing tesamorelin does really well is works on the liver. Because a lot of our clients who they do these massive cuts, they put an enormous burden on your liver and your kidneys. And so one of the things that tesamorelin has been proven to do in the clinical studies is it helps regenerate the liver. So a lot of the livers that had they were fibrotic, they had a lot of fatty liver disease or non-alcoholic steatosis or hepatic steatosis, the tesamorelin is able to reverse that. And it lowers cholesterol, lowered triglycerides by 20%, and also stabilized blood sugars. So think of that as kind of your ageless axis. Don't forget to add in some of the mitochondrial peptides along with MOTS-c, like 5-amino-1-MQ, SLOOP-332, SS-31. These are all great, but the best thing you can do if you're trying to create an ageless future is not just building your body and putting on muscle mass for now or the show that's coming up or whatever event, bikini season, swimsuit season. The best thing is think about what do you want your body to look like 10 years from now? And what can you do today to start activating that ageless future yourself? And so for those of you who want to go deeper, go to agelessfuture.com. My team will get your blood labs ran. We'll take great care of you. And then, by the way, I've got a free gift for you. If you just click on the link below, you can download a copy of my book, The Peptide Blueprint, absolutely free as a gift for you being part of this growing community. So I'm Regan Archibald. Appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next video.